What's up, guys? I'm Random Frank P, back with episode 93 of Room Tour Project, the series where we show off the best gaming setups. Each and every week, we put together a great collaboration for you guys to give you some ideas, inspirations for your setup. And if you see anything you like here, I have it listed for you in the description down below so you can check it out. But we'll start off episode 93. But first, a special shout out to Corsair as they're sponsoring this episode of Room Tour Project. Definitely check out their new Corsair Glaive RGB gaming mouse that is actually modular. You can switch out the thumb grips to really switch it up and make it fit your playstyle. With a 16,000 DPI sensor and 3-zone RGB lighting, this could be the next mouse for you. If you're interested, I will put a link to it in the description down below. First, we have the Saturated here with a nice black and white stacked monitor setup here. You guys know I love these. He's also got this nice galactic theme going on, judging by his wallpapers. But for those displays, his bottom monitor is an LG 29-inch ultrawide, and that top one is from Asus, that is a 34-inch ultrawide at 2560 by 1440p. Now down to his peripherals, a nice extended mouse pad here. He has a Logitech Performance MX wireless mouse, coupled with his Saber 68 keyboard with SA ice cap keycaps, and with the white LED lights inside his keyboard, it makes it shine up nicely. So a good job here with the peripheral customization to fit your setup's theme. As for his audio, he has the Logitech Z200 speakers, and you can see the ATH M50X headphones in white, a top choice. And now we're going to go into his PC, and this thing looks incredible. Inside his Inwin 301 case, again in white, he has the Ryzen R5 1600X on an MSI B350M Mortar Arctic motherboard, 16 gigs of G-Skill Triton Z RGB RAM, and a GTX 1070 from MSI. It is that Seahawk EK edition. So everything inside is water cooled with the RGB lights, and since it is a lot of white on the inside, the RGB lights are going to reflect off that. A really nice looking build. Then a quick peek underneath his desk, you can see he has the RGB light strip behind there, and keeping his cables nice and organized is this kind of like cable box. Great job on the cable management, and just a great job all together. I love how you match the black and white from everything to your peripherals to the wallpapers to match your sort of galactic theme. And that PC, as I mentioned, is just killer. Really complements your setup nicely. Next up is Michael here, double monitor setup on a nice long wooden desk and an overhead TV there off to the side for some Netflix and chill. But these are the type of bedroom setups that you can see a lot of work and dedication went into to make it what he envisioned in the beginning. For his dual monitors, his main display is an Asus PG34-8Q, it is at 34-inch ultra-wide, and off to the left is a 27-inch monitor from Acer here, both mounted on an arm bracket. And yet again, the wallpaper is complemented nicely by the RGB light strips behind his desk and that TV. Now into his peripherals, on again, another extended mouse pad here, this time from the glorious PC gaming race, is his Corsair Gaming K70 RGB keyboard with brown switches inside with Logitech G602 mouse. As for audio, underneath his desk mounted is the HyperX Cloud 2 gaming headset in black and red. Definitely still one of the best gaming headsets out there for that price point. You really just can't beat it. And one thing that's really cool that he modded to his PC is his on and off button that he has mounted underneath his desk. So it starts there, wires down to his PC so he can turn it on and off at the push of a button right at his desktop. Now again to the RGB lights here, and another great example of some sick RGB lighting inside the PC. Inside his NZXT S340 Elite case in white, he has the i7 7700K CPU with that new NZXT Kraken X52 AIO on an Asus Prime Z270A motherboard. Got that G-Skill Triton Z RGB RAM with an MSI GTX 1080. Nice. So I really like this one. Great job. Again, I still really like how you have both the solutions here for your double monitors and that mounted TV off to the right side for, you know, consuming some media, watching TV, watching Netflix there. It's overall a very tidy battle station as well, with a great use of RGB lights around your desk and inside your PC. And up top, some love to baseball. Always love setups that incorporate some personal stuff into it. Really takes it to a next level. Now we got a Vixium with a beautifully done triple monitor setup here, mounted so nicely. When you think of the stereotypical gamer setup, this is what always comes to my mind, and he pulled it off. Not only that, but for his L-shaped desk, he can game on the one side and have his laptop off to the right side. As for those monitors, all three are an Asus V247H. They're 24-inch monitors, and like I said, a great job on the mounting here. It's very level. If he wants to add some color with a handy dandy cheap RGB light strip behind the monitors, it adds some nice little pop to it, the orange going along with the sunset on his wallpaper. And yes, take note to his gaming posters above his monitors as well, all helps add to it. And since there's no dedicated photos of his peripherals, go over those now. He has the Corsair Vengeance K70 keyboard with the Razer Mamba mouse, because he's also got like an Xbox One controller there just in case, with a SteelSeries mouse pad. Then off to the right side with that L-shaped desk, he's got his laptop. Love the L-shaped desk for a use like this. That is a Dell XPS 15 and the Logitech MX Anywhere 2 mouse. Then down to his PC underneath his desk, you can see on top of his case, he has his headphones, which are the ATH M40X headphones. But inside is an i5 4690K CPU on an MSI Z97 G43 motherboard, the Corsair Vengeance Pro Series RAM, and a GTX 960 Strix graphics card. That's all inside the NZXT H440 case, and I do wish we had some photos for you, but unfortunately we do not. So this is really just another killer bedroom gaming setup. As you can see, it's right next to his bed actually, and at nighttime with all the lights off except for his desk lamp and the light strip behind his monitors, that's where I think this really kind of, you know, it sets the mood. It's nice and cozy, I think, and altogether just a really nice organized setup as well. Moving on through the show, this one is from Croak, an obvious Overwatch fan. This always is going to set it apart due to that dedication to that Overwatch theme. We're talking pop figures, the wallpaper, prints on the wall, even an Overwatch mouse pad. This is everything Overwatch lovers would love. So for those dual monitors, his main display is an Acer Predator XB271HU, an absolutely great gaming monitor. Then mounted vertically next to it on the left side is a 27-inch BenQ monitor, pretty much, you know, for, I guess, monitoring chat or doing things like browsing, Twitter, all that kind of good stuff there. I find it very easy to run out of justifications. But I'm digging those real graphic wallpapers. Now into his peripherals on his desk, he has the Razer Black Widow Chroma keyboard with Logitech G502 Proteus Spectrum mouse, got a glorious wrist rest there with a Moto 360 off to the left side on an Overwatch extended mouse pad. Damn. Then for audio, going with the Corsair Void wireless, surprisingly not Overwatch themed. Plus one for that Pikachu coaster, yo. And a pop figure lover, of course, Batman, Overwatch, Star Wars, you name it, he's got it. And leading into his PC, which looks crazy cool, I'm just gonna say it's safe to assume this is Overwatch themed as well with the orange and blue. I don't know, but either way, he has the Fantex Enthu Evolve case, that nice tempered glass side panel, with an i7 7700K CPU and an EVGA 1070 FTW graphics card. Not too sure on some of the other specs here, but yeah. Underneath his desk, doing a good job again with cable management for the most part. You see IKEA Signum keeping things off the ground, but a lot of cables wrapped around the leg and some tubes hanging down. At least it's not on the floor, right? So Overwatch lovers can definitely find a place in their heart for this one. Again, it's not only things like the peripherals and the wallpaper that matches it, but it's things like that print on the wall, having the RGB lights kind of go to the theme and the color of the wallpapers. I said it 100 times when you're matching stuff like that. It just really makes your setup look good. And this one's gonna be a little bit different here to round out the episode. This is a console gamer's bedroom gaming setup. When you think of the series Room Tour Project, this is more of a Room Tour submission. As for that giant TV, that is a 50-inch Samsung 4K curved TV, and underneath is a matching Samsung soundbar 8.1 audio setup here. But again, going with that whole curved, modern entertainment design and look here fits the setup well. And going along with his Xbox One S is that Xbox Elite controller, and for his headset there by his side is the Astro A50 wireless. I'm sure he's pumped about the Xbox One X. Now, one thing I gotta point out is how badass this is. I'm not really much into Legos. This is a Technic Lego Porsche GT3 RS that he built, and it looks insane. You can pick it up on Amazon along with that Mercedes Arcos truck behind it. But like I said, I haven't really played with Legos in a long ass time, but this looks really badass. So like I said, a bit of a different one here with a console setup, nothing really PC related here, but still fits the episode nonetheless, and still looks really nice for everything that it is, and everything he's done for it. It's a pretty killer setup. Alright guys, that'll wrap it up for episode 93 of Room Tour Project. I hope you enjoyed. If you did, give this episode a big thumbs up to show your support. Check the description down below, don't forget, of all the products you saw listed down there for you, as well as some instructions on how to submit your setup for a future episode of Room Tour Project. And if you saw some cool things but say you can't afford it, add it to your wish list on the Nice app, because each month we give away the 5 most requested things for free over there. So definitely do that. If you haven't already, hit that subscribe button. We got a ton of reviews coming out for the summer. You're not gonna wanna miss out on that, as well as any future episodes of Room Tour Project. Well, I'm Random Frank P. Hope you enjoyed. Have a good day.